behind the line. We're gonna get started in 3, 2, 1, go!
It's match 33. Let's see what we've got. We've got Provost moving across the line, 6506. They're headed across center field, but they're coming to a stop. Midfield up on the blue line side. I see some movement. Looks like 4669 is trying to line up on that gear. They didn't quite get it delivered, but the pilot has a gear in place. That's 5555. All three runs in the right side. Plus, we're moving now.
Oh, my God.
Yeah, we're tied up. That is a classic start. We're going to be seeing a lot of this today as our robots all begin moving in the autonomous mode. They get those first gears right away. But now we've got the second rotor moving on the blue line here. Good. Two successful gears.
Go, Brad.
Already got two blue lines for us. They're moving over to their retrieval zone behind that red airship. And on that red airship, there's the second rotor. We're still tied up at that 9595. These robots are moving, matching each other. I mean, even in this match, we'll never see who can pull ahead in the end. 1726. The nerds, they had one in their machine. They lined up, but didn't quite make it out of the airship. These gears are a tricky piece to handle. But they picked up one more. The nerds have another machine, and they're lining up. They're going to give it another go. Meanwhile, their line fires 14-58. They've got a gear over the red airship.
No.
And they're already making good progress to getting that third rotor moving.
Yes. Okay.
We're just under a minute left to play. We're still very close, and it's anybody's game. 1726 nerds. They're pulling it up. Everyone pulls it into the engine with success, and they load another gear on the gear train. More than likely, if anyone can do it in this final 30 seconds, it's time to board. There's another gear placed on the airship for the blue lines, and another placed on the red. But still, only two propellers each. It's going to come down to these climbs.